Kerbal Space Program, a game dedicated to the exploration and colonization of the final frontier. Outer space. There are so many beautiful places to go, so many things to do and explore out there in the vastness of space. So today, let's do exactly none of that, and try to beat the game without ever leaving the confines of Kerbin's atmosphere. In some alternate reality, many parallel universes away from the one where Bob became a god, Kerbals are absolutely terrified of the prospect of going to space. After all, who knows what kinds of horrors could lurk in the darkness beyond Kerbin? Aliens? Ancient space aliens? Humans? Horrifying. Some even say there could be a deep space kraken out there, just waiting for some poor soul to venture out of the safety of Kerbin's atmosphere. Truly a nightmarish place. Let's stay as far away from it as possible. Let us start a brand new career save with the wonderful name Kerbal Air Program, because the air is as far as we'll ever go. After being greeted by the lovely sound of non-existent birds, and after accepting a couple basic contracts, We rushed into the VAB to create our first ever vessel, the Flea, which we used to conduct the first flight of basically every single career game to ever exist. Once the Flea had landed, however, we switched over to the SPH to begin making our next craft. Yes, everyone, give it up for the Tumble Dryer! Consisting of two command pods attached to a girder segment, it's one of the most comfortable rides out there. It's also borderline impossible to control, which just adds to the amazing experience.
Just turn!
Using this amazing piece of cutting-edge technology, Jebediah and Bob, remember, different universe, Kerbin proceeded to roll their way around like an intoxicated pumpkin to a few KSC buildings, gathering temperature readings and mystery goo observations. Although I feel like I finally figured out what mystery goo actually is. It's the vomit all over the command pods after riding in this thing. This craft also essentially showcases how I plan to beat the game without ever leaving Kerbin, going to every KSC building and structure to perform every single science experiment. Essentially, my plan is to gather as much science from these as possible, so that I can unlock the mobile processing lab, the single most overpowered part in the entire game. From there, I could go back and collect science from every single location on Kerbin again, and unlock the whole tech tree. Theoretically, anyways. Easy, right?
Yeah, well, as I found out, not so easy. First, there's the issue of money, which, as you can see, after just a couple more launches and flights in a crappy airplane I made, one of which, Astrophobia 2, was the only time Kerbals will ever reach Kerbin's upper atmosphere, has already effectively softlocked me from progressing any further, because the amount of dumb little observational survey missions needed to get even R&D to level 2 would quite literally mean I'd be here for days. And, me not reading the fine print on some of these contracts didn't help either.
Wait, you're telling me I have to be above 19,200 meters?
Let me tell you something, Kerbal Motion LLC.
And with that, my attempt at beating career mode without leaving Kerbin was over. A challenge which, given enough time and disregard for your own health, might be possible, but simply isn't one that I'm interested in trying any further. At least I got to see some of the level 1 KSC buildings, I guess. This plane is almost as big as the administration building. And so, I tried again. Let us start Kerbal Air Program Part 2, but first I have to do everything I just did all over again. Fun. After essentially repeating my first few flights, tumble drying and all, it was finally time for me to create my first aircraft, the Chicken.
Nobody calls me Chicken.
Which I literally just used to go around the KSC and get a few buildings to tumble dry or mist, as me, in all of my wisdom, did not realize that the steerable landing gear doesn't have brakes, and I do not trust the fixed landing gear following the incident. This resulted in me doing one of the dumbest things I've ever done in KSB, driving all the way around the KSC with a parachute behind me like a drag car trying to stop. And then, in truly idiotic fashion, I managed to get the Chicken stuck on the slope leading up to the crawler way.
Oh yeah, and also the material study from Kerbin Shores swore at me, which I'm not sure how to take. Using the science data I collected, though, I unlocked actually good landing gear, and upgraded the chicken to the rooster, which I flew to a couple biomes near the KSC. I then did the same exact thing at the desert airfield, and that's when I unlocked it. The holy grail of this playthrough, the mobile processing lab, which is the single most overpowered part in the entire game. A part so good it trivializes unlocking the whole tech tree by effectively giving you 5 times as much science as you put in, pretty much for free. However, there's a catch. If you put data into it on the surface of Kerbin, you get a 90% penalty to the amount of science you can get from it. At first, this seemed pretty jarring, but then I remembered I can literally just fly the thing up into the air and get the normal amount of science, because reasons. Armed with this knowledge, I built the Dweeb, one of the worst aircrafts I've ever built in KSB. Like, you know the brick from my previous videos? I think brick would have been a better name for this piece of crap, as it sure flies like one. But before we do anything with it, let's upgrade the rooster to the turkey and take it to the North Pole to unlock solar panels to actually power the lab, and visit Santa's elf sweatshop, and fly/land in IVA with no UI, because these conditions are just about as VFR as you can ask for.
Ooh, Merry Christmas, Santa's must come this time each year.
Following this Arctic expedition, I unlocked solar panels, and proceeded to slap a comical amount of them to the Dweeb, which I then drove around to every single location at the KSC in order to collect data for processing, which took more than an hour thanks to the fact that the individual structures, such as the VAB fuel tanks and tracking station dishes, also count as biomes as long as you're touching them, of which some were mildly annoying to get. In the middle of this, Bob also fell off the Dweeb and was left to his fate. After all of the data had been collected, the Dweeb then took to the skies to place the data in the lab before landing to conduct research, which took more than 4 years, and more time because I had to take off again once to get more data back into the lab. Upon recovering the Dweeb, however, we were greeted with more than 5,000 science points. More than enough for us to unlock the remaining science parts, and guess what?
Chicken butt.
Do what you must suffer. Suffer needs to be done.
Hey man, what's going on?
Get out. We get to do it all over again. I then began doing it all over again with the new science parts, using the Dweeb 2, when this happened. In order to make the collection process less annoying this time around, I present to you the Dweeb tank. Called that because the piston I put out on the front of it makes it easier to grab onto the buildings and such, accidentally made it look like a tank. The KSC shall tremble in fear at its might and firepower of science. The funny thing is, on this mission, I actually had to collect every science experiment twice. As it turns out that when you put an experiment into the lab and recover that craft, you don't actually get the original science value from it. So you have to do it again.
Again!
Amazing.
Wow. Whoa!
Approximately 45 minutes later, Sebastian Kerman had once again collected every single science experiment possible from the KSC, and delivered the goods to the Dweeb 3, which will fly and then process the data once more. Not all of the goods, though. As the data in the second experiment storage unit was kept with the Dweeb tank to be recovered for another 1,000 or so science.
Dweeb 3 then made its flight, with the two dweebs, Bob and Lebo Kerman, making quicker work of the data, hilariously yielding another 8,000 science points.
Yes, science!
Using these stunning revelations about Kerman's dirt and mystery goo, which somehow helped us figure out how to build better rockets, we unlocked all but three nodes on the tech tree. The campaign had nearly been completed. It was now time for one final aircraft to be built, one flying laboratory to rule them all, in order to finalize Kerbalkind's knowledge of rocket science. The Mind Brain. Under the power of four Weasley jet engines, the Mind Brain took to the skies, from the island airfield, as I still had to collect science from them, and we began our quest to get science from almost every biome. Finally, we were left with one last biome to visit, the North Pole. After one final flight full of data collection, the Mind Brain landed on Kerman's northern ice cap, and scientists Bob and Sebastian Kerman began their grueling research once more. Research that wouldn't actually need to be completed, as after only transmitting 1,000 or so more science points, we already had enough to finish the tech tree and finish the game. The Kerbals had done it! They learned everything there was to know about rocket science without ever having to launch one into space themselves. Now the question remains, would they ever dare to launch one themselves? Could they muster the courage? And the answer is no. So what did we learn today, kids? The science lab is ridiculously overpowered, Kerbals are still deathly afraid of space, and someone should make this a speedrun category because it would be hella funny. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.